morning everyone, and welcome back to another vlog. So today is Monday. I am not sure what we're actually going to do today. Probably just going to be around the villa again, but I think we're going out for dinner tonight, so that should be nice. And of course I will bring you along with me for that. But yeah, welcome back to another vlog. So this is the third Menorca vlog now, I think, if I've done this right. I hope you're enjoying all the other vlogs so far. If you haven't seen any of them, I'll link them in the description box for you so you can go and watch the other two as well. But yeah, I have just woken up. It's about 11 o'clock in the morning. For some reason I'm sleeping really well here. I think it must be because I'm chilled and not thinking about a million things. And my bed's really comfy, so yeah, I'm sleeping really well, which is good. But yeah, I haven't long woken up, so I'm going to go down and get a drink and get some breakfast. And then I'm probably just going to come back up, get ready and just head on outside to the pool and stuff, I think. Just for another day of holiday antics. So yeah, that's where I'm at right now. So yeah, I'm going to hop off and I will pick you all up again, talk to you, probably with an outfit of the day. So I'll see you in a bit. I've just legged it upstairs if I sound a little bit breathless, but I just wanted to show you this bikini quickly before I actually take it off. So yeah, it's from Pretty Little Thing, but I got it on ASOS. I've had it since like April time. As you can see, it doesn't do me any favours in terms of the line situation, but I just adore the colours, like the blue and the yellow. I think it just pops against the tan really nicely. So yeah, I got it on ASOS. I'll try and link it in the description box. But I literally wear this purely for photos, which is really bad, but at least I'm wearing it. So, and it's not single use because I've taken this three times now. Three times? Might even be four. So yeah, but I just wanted to show you it and put it into a vlog somehow before I take it off, because now I've had my pictures taken in it for Instagram, because I am trying to get Instagram content as well at the same time. So yeah, now I've got my pictures. I'm basically like probably not gonna wear it, because the only thing is it's not very secure like up here. Like the bottoms are all right, but it's not very secure up here, so I can't really like play table tennis or anything, or like swim, because I just worry that they're just gonna fall out. And I've tied that like tight as I can, but it looks really cute in pictures and everyone on Instagram seems to really like it, so I just get a few pictures in it. And yeah, that's it. So I'll try and link it below, but I just wanted to give it a moment in the vlog. But I am gonna switch out a bit, so I will come back in a sec when I have switched. Ta-da! I've changed. I'm in my second bikini of the day, and this one is purely for tanning purposes. Again, it's the the triangle kind of shape bikini, which is my favorite for tanning because you get like minimal line situation. But yeah, this particular one is from Oysho. I got it in Venice. I will try and link it in the description box in case any of you want to go and have a look. In terms of sizing, I am a 14-16, as you know, and I pick a size L, which is the biggest size that they do in this particular one. Some of them had XL, some of them don't, which is a bit weird. But this one is an L, and I am a 14-16, like back size. So yeah, just for reference in case you're stuck. Yeah, I love this one. I love like the whole leopard print thing, which is very on trend right now. But I just love the style of it. Great for tanning, all that kind of stuff. I have got the matching pants on under my shorts. I just don't want that out, particularly with this one because the pants are a lot more skimpy. So yeah, I've just put shorts on just to hide it away. Yeah, these are my good old Primark shorts that I live in that you've seen already if you've seen the other Menorca vlogs and other vlogs of mine. So I can't link them because they're Primark, but 10 quid, they have them in like every colour you could possibly want or need. But yeah, they're just great, so, so comfy. Yeah, I'll try and link the bikini in the description box. If it's still available, I honestly don't know because I got it in a foreign country, obviously. So the UK website might be a bit different, but yeah, that's basically it. So I'm now just gonna head outside, just to tan, go in the pool, get on my Lilo, do bugger all, drink Fanta Lemon. Yeah, typical holiday chisel today. But yeah, the reason why I've changed is because, like I said, this one, because of the shape of it, it's better for tanning. Whereas with the blue one that I had on before in the last clip, because of the way that you put it on, it's almost like a jacket because it ties at the front into like this one, for example, clips up at the back. So because you tie it on at the front, the fabric at the back, you can't move on the blue one. So it means if I'd sunbathed or been in the pool with it, I would just get like a massive U-shaped line on my back, which would be impossible to get rid of. And I learned that the hard way when I wore it in Cuba, and I actually like wore it to the pool, and I got back into my room and my back just had a massive big, where the fabric had been, there was just a massive line. So I was like, oh, okay, maybe this one's a picture bikini rather than a tanning one. So that's a little explanation that I should have put in the last clip, but I didn't because I'm stupid. So yeah, anyway, I am now gonna head back outside, get my tan on and all that, and I will pick you guys up later on. Probably, I'm guessing, I'll speak to you again when I'm getting ready for dinner. So I have glammed myself up, which honestly makes me happier than anything else in the world. I love feeling like a princess, even though I don't like it right now, but anyway. So I've put curl mousse in my hair, which should dry naturally, hopefully, as we are walking and stuff. I've got a dress on from Nasty Gal, which I fucking adore. I've worn this, I got it for Venice, I think. Yeah, Venice. I've worn it so many times, I absolutely adore it. Just the way it just looks, and it's just really goes in at the right places and all that, so love it. I'll try and link it in the description box. I don't know if it's still available, but I'll have a good look. And then I've just got my watch and my ring and everything, and then my makeup, just simple and glowy. And then I ended up doing a little bit of a pink thing on my eyes, and just ended up smoking it a little bit, which I'm a little bit obsessed with. And then my lipstick, I've mixed two together, which someone will say you shouldn't do, but I love doing it. So it's two Charlotte Tilbury's mixed together. It's Walk of Shame and Electric Poppy. Electric Poppy's really bright, but putting the Walk of Shame over the top just mutes it a little bit. So it makes it a bit more wearable, so. And then I've just got my sandals on, which are from Shu, my Ride or Dies, which you've already seen. I absolutely love them. So yeah, all black, but all for a good cause, and I love wearing black against a tan. I just think it looks really nice. So yeah, I'm gonna head out for dinner and I will see you all later. No. Good morning everyone, and welcome back to another day in Menorca. Yeah, I ended things a bit abruptly last night, mainly because I was just tired, so but it was pretty clear that it was the end. So yeah, I haven't long woken up. It's about 10:45 in the morning. I just can't seem to get up this holiday at all. I think it's because I'm chilled and that my bed's comfy. So yeah, another sleep in, but making the most of it, because when I'm back at uni I'm gonna have, you know, 7 a.m. or even earlier starts to commute into the city. So yeah, I'm making the most of the fact that I can sleep in until late. But yeah, I'm woken up. I need to just take some medication and then I'm gonna go downstairs and have my breakfast because I'm starving. And I think I'm gonna have some bacon this morning because I've been having frosties like every morning. But we found some bacon in a supermarket yesterday, so I think I might have that this morning. We'll see in a minute what I end up having. But yeah, I just wanted to kick today off in terms of like starting the vlog and everything. Again, today we're just having another day at the villa because there isn't really anything to do around here, and the town itself isn't that great, and we were a bit disappointed. We were hoping there'd be like at least a gelato shop or a coffee shop of some description, but there isn't. It's not great. I think it's because where we go in Portugal, we're like spoiled, if that makes sense, because there's like coffee shops and there's vegan places now, which are great for me and my dairy issues. So we get kind of spoiled there in how nice it actually is. So here there's just literally nothing, so we're just going to be in the villa again today, and we're not eating out tonight because the Great British Bake Off is on tonight, and I made it very clear that I want to watch it because I can't wait until like Friday night when I get home to watch it, because everyone else will watch it and I'll get spoilers. So yeah, we're going to try and watch it on the TV if Channel 4 will work on the telly. So that's the plan for today. So another day of chilling and going to the pool, table tennis, that kind of thing in the villa. But I think we're gonna light the barbecue up again later. So that's the plan. So yeah, I'm now gonna get my medication out and go have breakfast, and I will pick you all up in a bit. It's a little bit later on, and as you can see, I have changed out of my pyjamas, finally. It's only like lunchtime, but anyway. So I just thought I would do a quick outfit of the day just to show you what I'm wearing. So bikini is from Oysho again, same as the brown one that I had on yesterday. Again, I bought this in Venice. Same time as the brown one as well. I just adored the colour. I don't really have much like mint green in my wardrobe. And not like just generally, like not just holiday wardrobe, but like just generally. And it's a very different colour for me, and I just absolutely love how this looks against the tan. I just think it just really pops out, because it's such like a cool toned pastel-y colour. So I just love that. They had moulds like in this bit, but I just took them out because I always do that. I cannot stand the moulds that they put into bikinis. Like, no one, hang on, I've still got it here. I literally just took it out. Like, sorry, but no woman I ever know has a boob shaped like that. I'm sorry, but it's just not realistic at all. So I always take them out. So I've just took them out. It looks so much better than when I tried it on at home with the molds in. It looks so much better now. So yeah, done that. I'll try and link it in the description box. And then I've got the matching pants underneath. I don't know if you can vaguely see that. Yeah, vaguely. So yeah, so that's that. Again, Oyshow, I'll link it in the description box if I can find it. And then my shorts are, again, same as the black ones. I'm not wearing the black ones. Shock. But yeah, I'm wearing these like acid washed blue ones, which I absolutely adore. These are probably my second favorite, second to the black ones. These are my favorite. I love how they look against a tan, again, probably because they're light colored. But I love the whole acid wash thing. I think it looks really nice. Again, these are from Primark and they were £10, so absolute bargain. I can't link these because they're Primark, but if you just go into your local Primark, they should still have them for a little bit longer before all the winter stuff takes over. It's really annoying because most of my holidays are in winter, technically. Like, one of our big holidays is New Year, but there's no holiday clothes in stores, like, at all, unless I go online. So, yeah, try and get hold of these before they disappear and for a bit. So, yeah, they're from Primark. Absolutely love them. So that's my outfit. I haven't got any shoes on because I can't be bothered, and I'm literally just going to walk outside, get these off, and go lie my sun lounger with a can of Fanta Lemon, I think. And I actually want to read my book today because I haven't actually read any of it yet while I've been here. And I really want to finish it. Like, I've got 30 pages left, right? There's not that much to read. So yeah, that's my plan for today. And that's my outfit. So I will link what I can. And if I can't find this one, I will link something similar. Really bad angle, but hey, thought I would say hello. Been in the same position for a few hours, and I only deviated to go in the pool for like 10 minutes just to cool off before I rolled over, because I was on my back, but I'm now on my front and tan on my back. So yeah, I'm chilled as hell, and I've just got a can of grape soda on the floor, which I'm drinking very, very quickly because I'm thirsty. But yeah, excuse me anyway, see? That's what happens when you drink too quick. But yeah, outside, it's lush, had a very, very chill day again. Yeah, just having a lovely time.
1 o'clock in the morning right now. But I ended up not filming like anything tonight, like at all, which I feel really bad about. But at the same time, I just didn't feel like picking up the camera at all. So just the way it goes. But I tried to film a few things, like as the evening progressed. So yeah, let's just fill you in. So had a barbecue, which was really nice. And then I came inside and I watched Bake Off on my laptop because I am a grandma. And Bake Off is the highlight of my week when it's on at home. It's the one thing I look forward to. And it's one of like the TV shows where when it's on, it's like my time. Like laptop goes away, my phone goes away. And I just watch it for an hour and I just have that hour just relaxing and just not doing anything except just watching that one thing. I've done it with Big Little Lies, I've done it with Killing Eve and a few other things. So yeah, I just watched it on my laptop because fortunately, because we have a Sky account and we have the Sky Go subscription, Sky Go is now available in the EU, so while we're still in it, I think like for a few more weeks or so. Anyway, I managed to access Channel 4 through that application on my laptop, so I watched it live through that, which meant that I wasn't going to get spoilers from people back at home watching it, which was really nice as well. So thank God for that. So I managed to watch that. So I watched that, had a drink while I watched it. It was a good episode as well tonight. Really enjoyed it, so... Made me very hungry though, and I ended up eating like a whole chocolate bar while I was watching it. So, whoops. But anyway, so yeah, watched that. And then I was just downstairs watching YouTube videos because I haven't watched much YouTube lately because I've just been so busy like up and down. Like before I came here, I was in Manchester, I was in Edinburgh, I was in London, I was just been so busy. And when I haven't been travelling, I've been at home either working or packing for the next trip. So I haven't had much time to just watch YouTube. So I went through my subscription boxes and I found a few videos that I like the look of. So I watched a few videos downstairs because the internet is strongest in the living room because that's where the router is here. So I was just in there watching some videos, which was just really nice to do. And I need to have a massive catch up when I get home from Menorca from everything else that I've missed. So... yeah, I did that, and then I just came up to my room and I was just like, you know what, I might read my book for a bit. So I actually have managed to read my book for the first time on this trip, which I'm very happy about, and I've literally got, I don't know, 10 pages left and then I'm going to finish it. So I'm so close to the finish line. Yeah, I know what the ending is though because I've seen the film, unless the ending in the book is different to the film. But I know, like, I remember watching in the film, like the part that I'm reading right now, and it's a bit of a sad bit, so but yeah, I'm really enjoying it, and I'm actually kind of sad that I'm at the end because I really enjoy reading it, even though it's been a bit more of a challenging read because it's an adult book rather than a young adult book, and there's a lot of legal jargon in there, but I've really enjoyed it. It's such a good story. So it's The Children Act by Ian McEwan, by the way, if I haven't said that sooner. So yeah, that's what I'm reading right now. So yeah, I've just read my book with Spotify on, listening to Madonna of all things. But anyway, that's what I felt like. So yeah, so I read my book and now I am going to go to bed because I actually want to be in bed before and in bed and asleep before 2 o'clock in the morning because that is what I've done every night while I've been here so far. So yeah, I am now going to go to bed and I will pick you guys up in the morning. Bye. Good morning everyone and welcome back to another day in Menorca. So today is our last but one day here, which kind of sad about in a way. Probably more sad tomorrow when it is like the last full day, so. But yeah, I haven't long woken up. I've just like opened my curtains and just taken my medication and stuff like that. because I have to wait 20 minutes after I've taken it until I can eat anything, because that's just how they have to work. So I'm gonna go downstairs like very shortly, because it's been nearly 20 minutes since I took it, so yay. But again, we're just having another day in the villa. I hope to god these vlogs are not boring. Like, I know we're not really going anywhere, but I mean, like, maybe in the last vlog we did like go out a little, but there's just not really anything here. Like, I feel really bad. Like, I wish there was stuff that I could show you. Like, I know, for example, in some of my other, like, my other holiday vlogs, when I went to Portugal, we found like a little beach, we went hiking on the cliffs, and like we were in the town a lot, and we actually went out, and it wasn't just me like by a pool as such. So I hope to god these vlogs are not boring. It's probably me just overthinking it, but it needs to be said out loud, because that is what I'm seriously thinking about. So yeah, I hope to god they're not boring, and I hope you're enjoying them. But there is literally nothing here at all. Like, me and mum were all a bit disappointed with the actual town itself. It is just a bit meh. So anyway, this is the way it is. So another day in the villa, so another tanning session, no doubt, for me. I've got one thing that I need to rectify. I have a line on my back. I was in the pool yesterday with my bikini on, obviously, and I've got a line from the back strap on my bikini, so gotta fix that. So I'm gonna have to sunbathe a bit to try and like at least smoothen it off. So I make that sound like it's the biggest chore in the world. But anyway, so that's the plan. We're just coming to the day in the villa, but I think we are going out for dinner tonight, so I will bring you along for that, of course, and show you my outfits along the way in that. So yeah, I'm now gonna go downstairs and get some breakfast, and I will pick you guys up in a bit. It's a little bit later, as you can see I've changed. I will show you my outfit in just a sec. But yeah, I've had my breakfast and everything, and I have just finished reading my book. Yeah, I'm not going to talk about it too much, because I am going to film a main channel video at some point, where I'm going to do like three books in one video and talk about them, like a three books I've read recently thing. I filmed one of those a little bit ago. It might be up by the time this vlog goes up. I honestly don't know, because my schedule with YouTube is a mess, but at least it is right now as I'm filming this vlog. By the time this vlog goes up, I might have sorted it out. We'll have to see. But yeah, I am going to keep that for a main channel video with two other books when I've read them. So yeah, but basically, yeah, I really, really liked it. I mean, I love the film anyway. But yeah, I really liked it. So that's all you're gonna get. So yeah, it was The Children Act by Ian McEwan, in case anyone's curious. But yeah, I'm not gonna say any more, because I'm gonna keep it for a main channel video for the near future. But I have got another book in my bag, which I'm gonna dig out and start ASAP, because I'm very excited about it. But anyway, enough book chat. Yeah, I am ready. I'm gonna go outside soon. I've just been checking my emails, because I'm waiting for stuff from uni to come through, like my timetable and the re-enrollment crap we have to do. But none of it's come through. Like, I'm a bit concerned. Like, I go back in a couple of weeks and I've had literally nothing at all. It's just all very last minute. General theme with my university, it's all a bit last minute and a bit rushed, so, which doesn't suit me, because I like to have things organized and planned and know where I'm at. Which, so, doesn't help. It's making me on edge a little bit, but it's fine. It's not my fault. So, nothing in my inbox, nothing I can do. So, just the way it is. Anyway, enough of me rambling about shit. I'll show you my outfit. So, this is today's look. Yeah, again, bikini and shorts duo, but the shorts won't be on very long. I just put them on while I'm
filming these little outfit other days for you, basically. So yeah, I've got this gorgeous bikini. It's from Primark. I fucking adore this bikini. I've mentioned it a few times now in like my Portugal vlogs and stuff. I absolutely adore them. If you haven't seen those vlogs, I'll link them in the description box. But yeah, I do mention this bikini in one of them, or maybe both of them. So yeah, I absolutely love it. It was bargain. I think the top was like £6 and the bottoms were like £5. Either way, it was around between £10 and £15 for both parts of the bikini, which is just crazy. But what I love most about Primark bikinis is that you can buy tops and bottoms separately instead of having to get them all together. So I got the top in a 16, which is perfect, and then I got the bottoms in an 18, I think. I think I did, can't remember, but either way. Even if I did get them in a 16, still great. They're still like separate and everything. But I think I did get these a bit bigger just in case. Good old Tum Tum here has a bit of a strop. So anyway, I absolutely love it. I love the polka dots and the colour and everything. Oh, I just love it so much. And like this style is just really, I find it really like supportive and everything. But I like how it does up as well, if you can see. But it's a clasp at the back, just there. And I find these clasps really easy to do up because they just click in. So love that. But yeah, obviously it's Primark, so I can't link it, but if you just check your local store, you might get lucky. And then again, you're gonna hate me because the shorts are also from Primark, so I can't actually link any of this. But again, the shorts are from Primark. These are like the mid blue wash ones. Again, they're £10, like all the other shorts I've shown you throughout these vlogs. And they're just on like tables, like stacked up, and they go from like size 4 or 6 to like 22, I think, or something, or 20. So quite a big size range for the high street, so it's quite good. So yeah, I love these. So this is my outfit. I feel bad that I can't actually link any of it, but like I've said before, I do get most of my holiday clothes from Primark because they are so affordable. So if they get covered in sand, sun cream, ice cream, food, Aperol, who knows, and then like chlorine and salt from like water and the sea and the pool and everything, it doesn't matter because they're really affordable. So I do get most of my holiday clothes from there, which I know sucks for you guys because I can't link it, but you gotta do what you gotta do. So unfortunately that's just the way it is, but Primark, just they kill it for me and I love it. So yeah, this is today's look, and now I am off to the pool to go and sit on my Lilo and do absolutely bugger all. So bye. So I've just finished like the children out, like I said, but I did bring another book with me because I'm all prepared like that, and I always take a spare just in case I finish the one that I'm actually reading. So the next book I'm going to read is this. It's Dumplin' by Julie Murphy, if anyone out there has Netflix. Dumplin' is actually a Netflix film with Jennifer Aniston in it, and I can't remember the girl's name that plays Willa Dean. But anyway, she's an absolute legend. I can't remember her name, but she's a legend. So yeah, I got this book when I was in Nottingham. I ended up going for a little solo adventure day back in like, was it July? End of July? Something like that. Or start of August, something like that. And I ended up in Waterstones for quite a long time, just walking through the shelves and just browsing, like having a really good look. And when I went up to the young adult section, there was one copy left, and I adore the shit out of the movie. So I thought, you know what, I really want to read the book as well because I love the film so much and everything that it stands for. So yeah, that's what I'm going to read next. So we've gone from hardcore legal adult book to a good old young adult classic. Well, not classic, but a good young adult book that should be easier for me to read. So not as difficult as that one, as much as I loved it, but yeah. That's what I'm going to read next, so stay tuned. Hopefully this won't take me too long to read, but can't promise anything because I am a slow reader and I get distracted really easily, and then especially with uni starting again, I'm not going to have much time to read, which sucks. So yeah, that's what I'm going to read next, so I'll let you know how I get on with it. So I've got some earrings in there from H&M. They're very extra and very bold for me. My lipstick is from Chanel. This is actually my prom lipstick that I wore to my high school prom, so it's quite special to me. And then this gorgeous dress is from Next, but it's a few years old, unfortunately, so I don't think it's available anymore unless you tried like secondhand or Depop to see if it was around there. But anyway, otherwise I would link it for you, but I don't think it'll be available. But I absolutely adore this. I've had it for a few years. I take it on pretty much every holiday I go on. It's like a holiday dress. Except the straps fall off because I have like no shoulders at all, but I love it. And then I've got my brown sandals on from Shoe, like my diehards that you've already seen before. So yeah, nice, relatively simple, but I've just gone like gold glowy on my eyes and then red lips to go with the dress. So it all matches. And then I've got my watch and my ring on my hands, respectively. And then I've just put curl mousse in my hair, as you saw in the other clip, me putting it in. And I'm just going to let it dry naturally. Hopefully it'll go curly. So it's my little OOTD. And now we're going to run off to go get dinner. It's about 11 p.m. We've come back from dinner, and I've come upstairs mainly to put like my phone on charge because the battery isn't doing so well. And I've just been on my laptop just checking emails and things. And I've got some tunes on, but I've just paused them. But yeah, dinner was lovely. I had sardines in case the clip wasn't clear. But they were really nice. I only ever tend to have them when I'm on holiday. It feels like a holiday like meal for me, so that was really nice. But yeah, I'm upstairs. I'm gonna go back downstairs in a minute though. I might start reading my book. I was gonna pick it up earlier today and I haven't, so oops. But I want a drink. I might go and get some gin because I've got some gin left and I need to use it up because tomorrow is our last day. So yeah, all the alcohol's got to be drunk, so I may as well have some fun. So yeah, basically I'm gonna end this vlog here, and then I'm gonna start again tomorrow for another one. So yeah, I'm gonna end this vlog here, but thank you for watching if you got this far. If you enjoyed this vlog, please give it a thumbs up for me. That would be so cool. And if you're new to this little part of the internet and you like what you see, feel free to click the subscribe button below as well. Yeah, I hope you're enjoying these Menorca vlogs. I'm having a great time filming them. I'm having loads of fun out here and it's really fun to share it with you guys as well. Like, I know this won't go up like immediately after I come back, but it's a memory for me and it means I get to share it with you, so it's really cool. So yeah, anyway, enough of me being sentimental. Thumbs up, subscribe and all that kind of stuff, and I will see you all soon for a brand new vlog. Bye guys.